And I've talked a lot about this, but I think tonight, before I take some questions, I really just want to discuss this. We have an ego because it helps propel us through a tough life, a hard life, a good life, but a lot of adversity, a lot of opportunity. And that's kind of our propulsion system. But men and women are designed to have that ego really in our development on this planet. Think about the magic of it. We're on this globe spinning through space at 20 plus thousand miles an hour, orbiting this huge sun. Actually, the Earth's going around at about 20-something thousand miles an hour. I forget how fast it's going around the sun. It's a lot faster than that. And we're way out here on the edge of the spiral arm of the Milky Way galaxy. The heavens are all around us. There's all this incredible life and all these amazing people that are around us. And it's such a magical thing to be alive and to be able to interact with people. And then to see Madison Avenue be able to convince us that life is boring and that life is empty, that is literally trafficking, like the Bible says, in the souls of men and women. I mean, almost every woman I've ever known, wonderful, beautiful, intelligent, radiant creatures. I don't care if they weigh 300 pounds or 100 pounds. They all thought they were ugly. Every man I know doesn't feel powerful. Almost every man I know, or at least they have that complex put into them, to where they've been made to feel inadequate by society and these archetypal images. And then I've studied history and the way people felt in the past, they weren't like that. And they have really robbed us of our souls so they can sell us a bunch of crap that doesn't matter while we are awake and alive with this incredible universe that is spinning around us. And I'm really stealing this line from a Charlton Heston movie, but I had this feeling the last few days, really intensely, but more than just the last few days, the last few years, but getting more and more intense. And the Charlton Heston movie's Planet of the Apes. You know, that he's in the spaceship at the start of the movie, and he's looking out in the cosmos, and they're going to be gone from Earth a couple thousand years, traveling at the speed of light, and he's realizing, out here, this crushes my ego. You know, I realize that none of the stuff I used to care about matters, and none of the issues that I was sold on really mattered. All that, you know, really matters is that I'm here with these, you know, couple astronauts out in deep space. I'm getting a little more esoteric than I normally get when I talk to people. But that's the way it makes me feel. And it's liberating, but also chilling at the same time, because I kind of need that ego to keep pushing and keep driving. I mean, even though I'm a good guy, I want to do good work, it still, I kind of need it to be about me a little bit to have that drive, and I'm losing that more and more. I remember years ago reading about John Lennon trying to lose his ego right before he was killed, and he was talking about how important that was to him. And I just feel blessed, because I have to tell you that it sounds like when I'm on the air and things, and it's not about me, but this is about an individual journey, and we all go through this. And I hope just by me talking about this, it can help you to hopefully, I don't mean to sound new agey, but go out there and look into this, that it is empowering, and it has really opened up my intellect and my psyche so much more. Because I've always been a giving person. I've always hated bullies. I've always tried to be a good person, but I also have that other side of me, like we all do, that's very dark and wicked. But to feel that diminishing, and then to be able to see the New World Order even clearer, as that ego diminishes and as that evil diminishes in me, I can see things so much clearer now than I ever did before. And it's like a blasting white light. It's so amazing. And I just want to tell people out there who feel inadequate or who don't see the majesty of life and who don't know how blessed we are and how amazing the gift of consciousness is, that we should all just deeply appreciate that, and that somehow just by taking that step and being thankful for life itself, that is something that will really free us. I don't know if that makes sense. And you look at these people, they are the complete opposite. I mean, I'll be watching an event, 3 hours of C-SPAN of the Queen of England coming, and there's all these titans of industry and former Secretary of States and Bush, and they revel in fancy outfits. I'm not saying a fancy outfit's bad, but it's the whole reveling in it. That's what it's all about. And walking up to the cameras and going, I'm a Grand Knight Commander of the Queen. And they're just so proud of it. In some monkey suit, some clown suit, talking about some Grand Knight Commander of some degenerate murdering family. That is not what human life is all about. That is not what we're here for. But they revel in being worshipped. They revel. They have no shame in it. Someone who had any humanity has shame in people looking at them and shame in people, you know, being into what they say. I have shame being here before you today. I have a lot of other feelings too, but I have shame because I don't feel worthy to talk to such incredible intellects and creatures living on this plane of existence. I don't know how to explain that. These people have no shame. They're totally greedy. Greedy to the point of they just want to kill everybody else so they can have it all. It's an instinct for control. They want to dominate everyone else. They want to just feed and feed and feed and do horrible things. And to them, piles of dead bodies and burning cities is beautiful. I remember reading writings of people that were with Hitler, and he just loved burning cities, and he loved dead bodies, and he loved black uniforms, and he loved, you know, all these mechanized precision troops, and Stalin loved it. Lenin, when he was killing millions, they said, what is the plan? What is the political program? And he said, just more blood, just kill more, just give me more blood. And they are the polar opposite of what we should be striving to be as good, decent, loving, happy people. Nurturative. All the good things. And they have committed themselves so greatly to darkness that they are threatened by the light and they just want to blast it out. The New World Order hates seeing happy, beautiful children run around in a park because they're not young anymore like that. They hate seeing you create good things. They hate seeing you be strong. They hate us living, and they're not going to stop until we stand up against them. So I don't, at some primitive level, relish war with these people. But because I've got to partake of it and I've got to face it, I'm going to do it with all of my passion. And I'm going to make sure in that process I don't become like them. And that's an everyday struggle. But if we're going to survive, they have to fall. Make no mistake, we're going to see. Make no mistake, we're going to see very serious things in the near future. And we're going to go through some incredible tribulations. But at the end of the day, as long as you maintain your humanity, no matter what they do, at the end of the day, as long as you don't compromise being a good person, that means being informed enough to know you're on the right path and not be deceived by them, we're going to win this thing.